Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is the first tutorial in another 3-part series. This next project is just so jam-packed with information, I couldn't possibly get it down to just one 7-Minute tutorial. Trust me, I tried. So instead of giving you a tutorial that's either super fast or just way too jam-packed with information, I decided to split it up over the course of the next 3 episodes. And the cool thing is, you can use the tips, tricks, and shortcuts from any one of the next 3 episodes in a number of ways with your own projects. In part 1, we'll create a logo animation using an image and 3 lines of text. In part 2, we'll create a really cool advanced reflection using fractal noise and compound blur. In part 3, we'll add some finishing touches which can be applied in a number of ways to countless other animations. You can take the tools you learn in each part of this series and apply them to your own projects to get professional, customized results. Please like this episode so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new tutorial. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know if this tutorial helped you out. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course and the project files for this series are in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Let's go to New Composition, 1920 by 1080. Make it 10 seconds long, and I'm going to call this Logo Animation, and just click OK. Now I've got my own logo in here for 7-Minute AE Tutorials. Just going to bring that in, and I'm going to resize mine down to 33%, so it's a little bit smaller. If you click your quotation marks, you can bring up your safe margins. P for position, I'm just going to move it over. I'm going to add in some text, so Control T to add in text. Jeff Knight, and actually I'm going to make some changes real quick. Let's just make this text white, and I've got mine set to all caps right here. And make sure in your paragraph settings, you have this set to left justify. Hit S on my Jeff Knight layer just to kind of increase that a little bit. Bring this over close to my logo. And Control R to bring up your rulers, and just bring a ruler to the top of your logo and then also to the bottom, because we want our text to line up with that. Make this a little bit bigger, and let's duplicate Jeff Knight. P for position. Underneath that, I'm going to type 7-Minute AE, and then duplicate that one more time, bring it down underneath, and just going to type tutorials. And you want to make sure that your text is blocked. What that means is that your left and your right margin are equal. So since this is left justified, our left margin will be equal. As you can see, tutorials is a little bit smaller than the other text, so just resize this to kind of make it about the same size. Just bring that down so that way our spacing in between is about equal. Bring this tutorials down a little bit more. Bring our 7-Minute AE up a little bit. Okay, so let's double click on 7-Minute AE and go back to our character panel. And I'm going to use my logo colors. Choose something kind of purple. Maybe make it like a lighter purple. And then I'm just going to copy this hex code, Command C, and then go to tutorials, double click, and change our color, Control V. And maybe make that a little bit darker so we have something with some contrast. Okay, so now I want to animate all of this. And the last 3 tutorials I've done have been on text animators. So if you're not familiar with this, just go back and watch those tutorials if none of this seems familiar. So let's open up our Jeff Knight layer, highlight text, animate. Want to add in a position text animator. And we also want to click animate and enable per character 3D. Okay, so this animation is going to be dictated, if we open up a range selector, by our offset. And these percentages are dictated by our shape. Okay, so it defaults to a shape of square and offset of 0. So let's change this to ramp up, and we want to change our offset to -100. The range for ramp up is -100% to 100%. Put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation, go for 20 frames, and then increase that to 100%. There's no difference, and that's because we haven't adjusted our position here. So for our position, just click on that, and we just want to pull this text back because we're going to be coming in 3D space. Make it where it kind of comes in towards the center. So just pull this back till it's off screen. Okay, I'm just going to loop that, and I want this to come in a random order. Go down to here to randomize order and click that on. It defaults to off. And let's increase our ease load to 100% so that way it comes in fast and then stops slow. Okay, so that's for Jeff Knight. Let's animate our 7-Minute AE. Again, click on text, go to animate, and we're just going to add in a position text animator. And we want this position to start over on the right. So just move this over to the right. And again, open up our range selector and advanced, change our shape to ramp up, our ease low to 100%. And I'm going to change our based on instead of characters to words. We'll go back to the beginning of our timeline and remember our offset is negative 100% keyframe. Go 20 frames up to 100%. Okay, and we want to mask this text. And the way we do that is go to where the animation ends, right click, mask, new mask, and it puts a mask around our text. So if we watch that playback, we can see how it comes on. The reason why I say go to the end of the animation, I'm going to take that mask off. So I'm just going to back out of that. So see, there's no mask. Now, if I put the mask on, say like right here, it will mask it at this point, and that's not the effect we want. So go to the end of the animation, right click, mask, new mask, and that's our animation. So now let's do our tutorials text line. So open that up, text, animate, position, and let's move this down so it will come up from the bottom. Open up a range selector and advanced. Again, we want to change our shape from square to ramp up, our ease low to 100%. We want to make this randomized order and leave it at characters. Go back to our offset and go to negative 100% and put a keyframe there. Go forward 20 frames, 100%. And again, we're going to right click, mask, new mask. And we can watch that playback. This is the look that we get. And if we want the characters for tutorials to come in a little bit quicker, we can just lower this position from our text animator. Right now it's set to 42, maybe make it like 200. So see, now it'll come in a little bit different. Okay, and I just kind of flew through these text animator animations because I've just done 3 tutorials on how to use text animators. So again, if this seems unfamiliar, just go back and watch those if you're having any difficulty understanding the way these act. So now we just need to animate our logo, use position and hit Shift T to bring up our opacity, put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation, go for 20 frames and just copy those keyframes. And let's go back to the beginning. Now let's set our opacity down to 0% and we're going to move this off camera like that. And now for this second position keyframe, let's right click, keyframe assistant, ease in. Let's go to our graph editor and pull that in all the way. So now if we watch it play back, and I actually want it to fade in a little bit later. So maybe go forward about say 5 frames and pull that first opacity keyframe that's set to 0% in. And we can also move this second one in a little bit. Highlight those, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. And we get something that looks kind of like that. So this is our logo animation. Let's highlight by choosing Command A to grab all of these layers and click Motion Blur. So that way these all have Motion Blur set on them. Okay, so in the next episode, we'll be adding in an advanced reflection using compound blur as well as a camera movement. And in part 3, we'll be adding in some finishing touches. Now, you can use this animation on its own, but I highly recommend that you come back for part 2 and part 3 to learn how to make this logo animation look super cool. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this tutorial. Come back next week for part 2 of this 3-part series. We're going to create a really cool advanced reflection using fractal noise and compound blur. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course and the project files for this series are in the description below. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.